Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulihil Kareem amma ba'd. An Arabic noun must have four characters. As you already know, one, its kind, that is whether it is definite or indefinite. Then its number, whether it's singular, muthanna or plural. Then its gender, whether it's masculine or feminine. And finally, its i'rab, that is status in an Arabic construction or a sentence, that is whether it's in the form of rafa, in the form of nasab, or in the form of jar. We have studied in detail i'rab, gender, and now we start with the number. As I introduced in the beginning, that in English there are only two numbers, singular and plural. A noun used for one is called singular or wahid, and in English a noun used for two or more is called plural. But in Arabic there is a separate noun for two, and that is called muthanna. Our heading is adad, a number, and we have three under this heading. Wahid are singular, a noun used for one, and then you have a separate noun for two, that is called muthanna, a noun used for two. Since this doesn't exist in English, so we don't find exact word for muthanna, so it's better to remember it as such. In some books you will find the word tasniya for this, but this is not the correct word. Tasniya means the act of making a muthanna from wahid. The exact form, the exact name of the form is muthanna. Then you have jama. Pronunciation is wahid, muthanna, and jama, plural. Wahid, muthanna, and plural. Plural, remember, this will be the noun in Arabic used for three or more. A noun used for three or more. So wahid is a noun used for one, muthanna is the noun used for two, and jama is the noun used for three or more. First we will study muthanna. As it should be clear by now in your minds that every noun has to have four characters. So we would be studying muthanna, and there will be no form of muthanna without the consideration of whether it is definite or indefinite, and so would there be no form without the consideration of whether it is masculine or feminine, and also there will be no form without the i'rab. The forms which we will make, they will be with reference to i'rab as well as with reference to its gender. How to make or constitute a muthanna form? How to make or constitute a muthanna form. It has a universal formula applicable to all the nouns, whether definite or indefinite, whether masculine or feminine. But the form of i'rab will be separate. So first we will study that in the rafa form, first in the rafa form, in the form of rafa, a singular noun in the form of rafa will be transformed to muthanna by, so this line say is the singular form in rafa form, and this is its last letter. For example, I can say a pen in Arabic is called qalam. I'll write it for your convenience in two colors. Qalamun in rafa form, a pen. In rafa form is qalamun. In nasab form is qalaman. And in jar form is qalamin. So we are taking its rafa form. Qalamun, a pen. I indicate its this word in two. That is the last letter. I'll indicate last letter of the singular form, I'll indicate in red color, and the word before that, whatever is the number of letters in it, that will be in the blue color. So I'll indicate like this, small line is for the last letter in red color, and the word before that is in blue. So to convert this word to musanna form, what we will do is, we will give a fatha to the last letter. Now this is in black color. And then we'll add alif followed by a noon with kasra to produce an ani sound in the end. The end sound would be ani. Remember, this ani sound at the end is the typical indication of musanna form in rafa. So the musanna of qalamun would be qala. You know, the letter meem will remain unchanged, but its harkat will change. So this would become qalamani. Qalamun, a pen in singular form, in rafa form, a pen in rafa form, and its musanna would be qalamani, two pens in rafa form. So right from the very beginning, you should learn to have the concept of i'rab in every Arabic noun. So say qalamun is a pen in rafa form and qalamani are two pens in rafa form. Now you can take any number of examples. Ainun is an eye in rafa form, and two eyes in rafa form would be ainani. Ainun is an I in the rafa form, and its musanna would be ainani. No, fatha at the top of noon followed by alif and noon with kasra. Ainani, two eyes in the rafa form. Udunun, an ear in rafa form, its musanna would be udu, but its harkat will change to form followed by ani. Udu nani, two ears in the rafa form. Then you have yadun, a hand. Its musanna would come up to be, you know, in this case, the word comprises of only two letters. So the last is dal, so it is in red color, and before that is only one letter, that is ya, that is in blue color. Then you would have dal, letter dal, but its harkat would change to fatha, followed by alif and noon with kasra, yadani, two hands in rafa form. Then we have some complex words. Mu'minun, a believer in the rafa form is mu'minun. So its musanna would be fatha and then ani, mu'minani, two believing. Then you have a Muslim man. A Muslim man in Arabic is muslimun. So this will change to musanna in rafa form as muslimani, two Muslim men. Next is musanna in nasab and jar form. Musanna in nasab and jar form. We take the same examples as we took in rafa form. The first example was qalamun in rafa form. A pen in rafa form is qalamun, and a pen in nasab form is qalaman. A pen in nasab form is qalaman. And a pen in jar form is qalamin. Qalaman, qalamin. Qalaman, a pen in nasab form, and qalamin, a pen in the jar form. Both of them will be converted to the musanna form in the same way, that is the last letter and the word before that. A long line and a small line in this case too, to convert to musanna form, the last letter of the singular form will be given a fatha followed by a ya with sukoon. Sukoon can be indicated in two ways, this and this way. Both are correct. So, musanna, the last letter of the singular form will be given a fatha followed by a ya sakin and a noon with kasra. So in this example, this will be qalamaini. So qalaman and qalamin both will be converted to nasab musanna form as qalamaini. Qalamaini, two pens in the nasab or jar form. Qalaman, qalamin, a pen in the nasab form, a pen in the jar form, and musanna form, two pens in nasab or jar form would be qala maini. Then we had the example of an I. In the nasab form, it will be ainan. Ainan. And in the jar form, it will be ainin. And the musanna for both of them would be ainaini. Ainaini. Then you have an ear in the nasab form, udunan. Udunan. And an ear in the jar form would be udunin. Musanna for both of them would come up to be Udunaini. Udunaini. Qala maini, ainaini, udunaini. Then we had in rafa form an example of a believing man. In rafa form it was muminun, and in nasab and jar form it would be Mu-mi-nan. And in jar form, it will come up to be mu-minin. And musanna for both of them would be same. And it will be mu'minaini, two believing men. Then a believing Muslim in nasab form would be musliman, musliman in nasab form, and Muslim man in jar form would be Muslimin. And musanna for both of them would be Muslimaini. Muslimaini. So again, I am emphasizing that earlier you make your reflexes according to the Arabic language, easier for you would be to learn the Arabic language. Whenever you think of a noun, you must have the habit of imagining or bringing to your imagination simultaneously its four characters. That you have to call to your mind, whether it's singular or musanna or plural, it's definite or indefinite, it's masculine or feminine, and its form of Arab. So, in nasab and jar form, a pen is kalaman in nasab form and kalamin in jar form. And just to complete, you can say kalamun in rafa form and kalaman in nasab form and kalamin in jar form. And musanna in the rafa form would be kalamani, and in nasab and jar form it will be kalamaini. Then you have I nun in rafa form, and musanna was ainani, and ainan and ainin is in nasab and jar form, and I, and Musanna is Ainaini. Then it was Uzunun in the last heading, that is in the Rafa form, and Ear. But in the Nasab and Nasab form, it was Udunan and Ear, and the same and Ear in the Jar form is Udunin, and Musanna of Nasab and Jar form is Udunaini. Then a Muslim man in Rafa form, Muslimun, and Musanna Muslimani, in Nasab form, Musliman, Musanna Muslimaini, and in Jar form, Muslimin, and Musanna Muslimaini. Then you have the Arabic of a believing man is Muminun in Rafa form, Musanna was Muminani, and a believing man in Nasab form is Muminan, and in the Jar form is Muminin. Musanna of both of them is Muminaini. One note, just keep in mind, as I said in the beginning of Musanna, that it has a universal rule that any singular form in Rafa form will be converted to Musanna by the addition of Ani sound at the end, and in the Nasab and Jar form, it will be converted to Musanna form by adding an Aini sound at the end. But in the plural, this will not be the case. In plural, the masculine forms will be converted to plural form in a different way, and the feminine forms will be converted to plural in a different way. Now the next heading is Jam'un, that is plural. That is the noun used for three and more. Noun used for three or more. This is just to remind you that in Arabic, jama form or plural form starts from three. And for two, there's a separate form, musanna, because in English, musanna form doesn't exist, and the plural form starts from two, and then it continues. In Arabic, like in English, you can say, plural is of two forms, of two types. Regular plural and irregular plural. Or regular, you can say classical. And irregular, which has no rule. Normally, in English, a singular is converted to plural by the addition of S-R-E-S at the end. A singular is pen, and the plural is pens. Singular is hand, and the plural is hands. But singular is foot, but the plural is not foots. What is the plural of foot? Feet. So this is irregular, not classical. These two are classical, regular by law, by rule. But foot converts to plural form not by the addition of S-R-E-S, rather it is converted by breaking the singular form. You know, in these two, if you see carefully, the pen, the word pen is intact here. The word hand is intact here. Only the addition has taken place. The addition of S-R, sometimes E-S, makes the singular form converted to the plural form. But here, the word foot doesn't exist in the plural form. So, this is
irregular or broken, you can say. The original singular word is broken while getting converted to the plural form. Likewise is the two types of plural in Arabic too. There is a regular way of conversion from singular to plural form, but there are numerable, a very great number of nouns in which the singular form is broken while getting converted to the plural form. So there are two types in Arabic. One is called Jama Salim and the other is called Jama Mukassar. Mukassar means broken. Salim means conserved. Unbroken. You know, the singular word is kafir. A non-believer. Kafirun. Kafirun is a non-believer. It has got two plurals. One is kafiruna. Kafirun. Kafirun. Its plural is kafiruna. The word is kafirun. A non-believer is in the rafa form is kafirun. It has got two plurals. One is kafiruna, but it has got another plural too, parallel to this, and that is kuffarun. Kuffarun. See, the whole word is broken. This word kafir does not exist here, but it does exist here. So this is Jama Salim, unbroken form of plural. And this is the broken form of plural. We stop it here today and we'll continue next time from here, inshallah. Akhru da'wana, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen.